Welcome to Conversations Live. For more than a decade, we've brought you the best in books, entertainment, celebrity interviews, and current events. When the movers and shakers of the world have something to say to you, they say it to us first. Here's your host, Cyrus Webb.
Welcome back, everyone, to Conversations Live. I'm your host, Cyrus Webb. Glad you all could join us once again. For a radio audience tuning in at WYAD 94.1 FM and WYADonline.com, we're glad that you all can be with us. Also, joining us online worldwide via our podcast at iHeartRadio and Amazon Music, we're glad you all could be with us as well. We're excited to welcome historian Steve Wiegand to our broadcast today. Steve's written a book about an individual I have to admit I had no idea who they were, but their story is so inspiring. The book is called The Uncommon Life of Denny O'Connell, A Tale of Baseball Cards, Average Players, and the True Value of America's Game. We're going to talk to Steve not only about the writing and research for this book, but also what it's been like for him to introduce to some, like myself, and to reintroduce to others who Denny O'Connell was, his impact on sports, but also his passion for the game as well. Steve, thank you so much for the time today. Really appreciate it.
Well, thank you for having me on.
Well, this when this book was first pitched to me, Steve, I love to read, I love to learn. I had no idea who Denny O'Connell was. But I have to also admit, my brother is a sports guy in the family, so unless there was a book already written about him that I had read, I would not have known who he was. But I love the fact how you're able to not only share Denny O'Connell's life, but also what really was the spark in his life, and that was his love of sports. What has it been like for you, Steve, through this book to be able to share Denny's story and his impact?
Well, you used a great word about it earlier on, and you described in the book. It was inspiring. The origin of the book was baseball cards, and back when dinosaurs still roamed the earth, I collected baseball cards as a kid, and every pack I bought had a Denny O'Connell card in it, or so it seemed. I had no idea who the guy was, and I didn't care. I knew he wasn't Willie Mays or Mickey Mantle or any other big baseball hero. But then when I read a couple of years ago, I read stories about what baseball cards were selling for, and it came to mind the Denny O'Connell card that I'd collected. So that kind of led down the rabbit hole. I researched his life a little bit, and the more I looked at him, the more interested I became in who this guy was, because his baseball card in collecting parlance is a common, meaning it's not worth very much. But his career was anything but average, and his life was anything but average. And I got fascinated with the guy, and that's where the genesis of the book came from.
Wow. It is a book of Denny O'Connell's life, for sure, Steve. But it also is, it really helps you through the backdrop of history to kind of know where he was, the impact he was able to make, and also what was happening around him. I did not know, again, when I began reading the book, I would find I'm here on the radio side of Mississippi. Mississippi is referenced in the book. You talk about the killing of Emmett Till. So we're able to get the historical references as well. Talk to us about that. Did it feel like you were telling, in many ways, two stories here, Steve? One, the story of this baseball player, but also the life that he was living in and what was happening in the world around him.
Yeah, maybe even three, Cyrus, because it was a story of Denny O'Connell's life, which is, to my mind, is fascinating because it was sort of a rags-to-riches story, even though he was never a star. It was second, as you said, baseball reflected what was going on in America the rest of during his decade, which is basically the 1950s. And it also was the story of baseball during that period, which is often referred to as the golden era of Major League Baseball. So you had those three threads that kind of wove together. I will point out, you mentioned Emmett Till. Denny O'Connell's first professional year was 1946, which is also Jackie Robinson's first professional year, or at least in what's considered organized baseball. And so baseball was dealing with integration and all the issues that dealt with race relations at the same time that America was. And
right.
So that's sort of reflected in the book as well.
That's true. And I think, too, for anyone who does not know, as I did not know Steve, Denny, I think one thing, even taking sports out of it, I think any of us who have a passion and love for something will be inspired by him. You talk about in chapter 10, probably one of my favorite chapters, O'Connell's A Natural Pop-Off. One of the things that you wrote in the book, I actually want to read this because I think, again, we can substitute baseball for, again, anything that we are passionate about. You wrote this, but money had never been much of a motivating factor for O'Connell when it came to baseball. He truly loved playing the game, and even more so when he played it well. And again, I think that's part of the connection I started to feel with this book, Steve, is that, yes, it was the story of Danny O'Connell, but it really is the story of a lot of us who may not be household names, may not be individuals that you would recognize, but are truly good at what we do and maybe just as passionate as those that we do know. Talk to us about that aspect. What was it like for you to see how, even later on in the book, as you chronicle in his life, that he wasn't, the money part wasn't it. He knew what his talent and gift was, and that's what he relied on. What was that like for you to be able to share?
It was a real eye-opener, Cyrus, because, as I said before, I didn't know anything about this guy. I knew that he was a professional baseball player. But when I got into his story, as you said, he was a guy who was good at he was good enough to play at the highest level of what he loved to do. But he loved it so much, so it was a double blessing for him in terms of he got to do what he loved. He did it as well as he could, and he did it at the highest level of his chosen occupation. And at the same time, he provided for his family. He died tragically at the age of 40, not to spoil the end of the book, but he qualified for a Major League Baseball pension, and that allowed all four of his kids to go to prestigious colleges and have successful careers. So he provided for his family. He went to work every day. He did the best he could, and he loved every minute of it. And I don't know that you can do much more in life than that, even though he was not, you know, a Hall of Fame caliber player.
Yeah, I think that is it. I love the fact that you talk about, of course, as this life goes on, you take us into to 1960. And the fact that, again, he was passionate enough to know what he was good at, but also to know his worth. You have in the book the conversation, Steve, with Doherty, where he says, "I'm a better baseball player than most of the fellows. You're going to pay more, but you know you can sign me as a free agent." So he realized it really again shows for him it wasn't even about the money. It was about to me, Steve, as a reader, it really was about him. Not only, of course, being able to do what he was passionate about, but to show his value, to show his worth. Is that something that you picked up on as well, that at the end of the day, he was, again, like a lot of us, just wanting to know that his life and what he did mattered?
Yeah, and you bring up an interesting point about him as well. And he wasn't obviously the only guy that was like this, but he was the quintessential team player. He was loved by his teammates. He went out of his way to help his teammates every way he could. In fact, a couple of times in his career, a young player was coming up that wanted to take his position and take his job. And O'Connell realized that for the good of the team and the success of the team, he had to help this kid get to be a better player. So he went to work. He loved not only his job, but he loved the profession or the industry he was in. And he wanted to make it better and make the people around him better. And, you know, people that can go to work every day and like what they do are much better off than people that make a lot of money and hate what they do.
Right. So I have to ask you then, as you mentioned here, Steve, you went into this book not knowing a lot about him. What was one of the biggest surprises or revelations for you as you got to discover Danny O'Connell?
Well, I was surprised because I've been a lifelong baseball fan, and I have to confess, I'm kind of a statistics nerd. And when I got into his statistics, I found that he was not an obscure player when he was playing. He was in his league's top 10 in a lot of categories. He held the consecutive games hitting record for the Pittsburgh Pirates for 50 years. He was one of the better fielding players during his career, and that surprised me because, frankly, as I said, I never heard of the guy other than seeing his baseball card, and I was surprised to see just how valuable it was, and that sort of goes to how he lasted for 10 years in the big leagues. The average career in the big leagues is less than 5 years.
So I have to ask you before we let you go here, Steve, and again, I appreciate the time. We're going to remind our audience that they can get the book. Let's talk about the why. Why do you think we don't know more about Danny O'Connell?
I think because as a country and maybe as humans in general, we are attracted to heroes. We are attracted to people that excel at whatever they do, whether it's movie stars or athletes or politicians. And if you think about it, Cyrus, a baseball team has 25 guys on it. One of them is Willie Mays, and the other 24 are Danny O'Connell.
Got it.
You may idolize the hero, but you can affiliate yourself or recognize yourself in the average player. And I dedicate the book to all of us in life who have hit 260 and are happy with it. So. That's what I think his worth is.
Love that. Well, it's a great book, Steve. And again, for our audience out there, whether you are a baseball fan or not, you will definitely be inspired by it, I think, if you're a creative in any sense of the word or just passionate about something that you love, about the importance, I think, of not giving up, being focused on that and not let the distractions or the trappings of fame and fortune get to you and show you that you can still be a winner in your own eyes and the eyes of others. Again, everyone, historian Steve Wiegand has been our guest. The book is The Uncommon Life of Danny O'Connell. It's available through our friends at Amazon.com or through your favorite local bookstore if they don't have it. I know they'd be more than happy to order it for you. Steve, really appreciate you spending some time with us. How can our audience stay connected with you?
Well, you can contact me through the publisher, which is Bancroft Press. You can Google it and find it. I also have an Amazon page, an author page, and I can be contacted through that as well.
All right. Well, Steve, congratulations to you again. Really appreciate the time and looking forward to a next chat together.
Thanks very much, Cyrus.
More than welcome. And we thank your audience for tuning in to another great segment of Conversations Live. Until next time, I'm your host, Cyrus Webb, saying, as always, enjoy your day, enjoy your life, enjoy your world. Thank you all for choosing Conversations Live. Now, let's go make today amazing. Take care.